Hello everyone, and welcome once again to your very own channel, Easy and Effortless Economics. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss about one of the very important concepts of microeconomics, that is your multiplier and accelerator. But before starting with multiplier and accelerator, first let's understand what actually is multiplier and what actually is accelerator. To make it more simplified, multiplier is basically the relationship between investment and income, that how much investment is being done and as a result what return you are going to get out of that. And what about accelerator? It is a relationship between consumption and investment. So first let's understand what is multiplier, then we'll move ahead with the accelerator. Okay, so multiplier says that it shows the effect of changes on investment on changes in income. It says that how with the change in the income, suppose if you have made an investment of some amount, what return you are going to get, how it's going to multiply the money that you have invested into the economy or that you have invested into any sort of the bonds or anywhere you have invested. So what is multiplier? It is the effect of change in investment on and the change on income. So it is the relationship between investment and income. There are two types of multipliers. Two different economists have given up their own ideas, have come up with their own ways of expressing or defining multiplier. One is your Kahn's employment multiplier and the other one is your Keynes income or investment multiplier. So first, let's see what is Kahn's employment multiplier. By the name, you can understand that employment multiplier is all about generating employment opportunities. So it says that when the government take up the projects, for example rails, irrigation, so different plans of different activities were taken up by the government or new departments were set up, so for that more manpower is required. So more manpower means more generation of employment opportunities. Employment means which will lead to generation of income, so they are getting income, so that income will be spent on the consumption of goods. So when the demand for good increases, what will happen when the demand for goods increases? It will require more manpower. So this is how it works. You have got the idea that employment opportunities are created. How? New departments or new projects were taken up, manpower were involved, then they get the salary, they were paid, and the amount that they are getting, the income that they're investing on consumption. And when the demand for consumption goods arises, what will happen? More and more people are going to buy or purchase consumer goods, or they need more goods. So more industries of that particular product requires to be set up. So this is how it is helping in creating employment opportunities. This is Kahn's employment multiplier. Now let's see what does it says. According to Kahn's employment multiplier, when government undertakes public works like roads, railways, irrigation works, then people get employed. This is initial or primary employment. Means first part of the employment is that new departments were set up and they have got the job. These people then spend their income on consumption goods. Now they get the income, they get the salary. So now they are investing on consumption goods. As a result, demand for consumption goods increases, okay, which leads to increase in the output of concerned industries, which provides further employment to more people. So now they are investing on consumer goods, so the demand for good increases, so it requires more industries to be set up. More industries means more people will be employed. So this is your employment multiplier. Now coming to the second part, that is your Keynes income or investment multiplier. It says that how the income that is multiplied to, how many times the income is multiplied. Suppose you made an investment of 1,000 and how that 1,000 increases to 5,000. This is your investment or income multiplier, that how your income increases over a passage of time. So let's see what does it says. Keynes income multiplier tells us that a given increase in investment ultimately creates total income, which is many times the initial increases in total in income resulting from that investment. It means the investment that you have made, and that investment you have made for 1,000, and how many times or how many folds that income has been increased. That is why it is called income multiplier or investment multiplier. Income multiplier indicates how many times the total income increases by a given initial investment. So these are the two types of multiplier that have been given by two different economists. One is your Kahn's, that is your employment multiplier, which says generation or multiplying or multiplication of more and more employment opportunities. And the second part is your Keynes income multiplier, which says that how your income multiplies over a period of time. Now the question arises that how this multiplier can be calculated. So we have a formula for multiplier. You can see multiplier is denoted by K. So K is equals to change in real GDP upon change in injection. Okay, change in real GDP means, you know, the total value of goods and services, but real GDP is like it is calculated after making the adjustment for the inflation, or you can say it is calculated at constant prices. This is the only difference between real and nominal GDP. In nominal GDP, the constant prices are not there. They don't consider inflation. Whereas in real GDP, it is calculated at constant prices. Then you can see upon change in injection. There are two concepts in economics. One is your injection and the other is leakage. So first see what is an injection. Injection are basically additions of money to the circular flow of income, the additions to the economy. Example, investment, export payments. So these are considered as your injection. Then the other concept that you can see is your leakage. What is leakage? Leakage means withdrawal of a part of money from the circular flow of income. Example, saving, taxes by household, firms, or import payments, etc. So later on you are going to see in the role of leakage and injection in the multiplier, but as of now we just have to focus on the formula. So it says change in real GDP. As I told you, real GDP means which is calculated at the constant price after making the adjustment for the inflation upon change in injection. Injection means the additions of money to the economy. Then the other way to write the formula is K is equals to 1 upon 1 minus MPC. MPC is marginal propensity to consume. Marginal propensity to consume shows the relationship between consumption and income. That with the increase in income, what level of consumption or what change in consumption is taking place. So this is your MPC. Or if MPC is given, if MPS is given, MPC can be calculated by 1 minus MPC is equals to MPS. So the second part is 1 upon MPS. MPS is marginal propensity to save. This is, it shows the relationship between saving and income, that with an increase in income, what change in the savings are going to take place. So this is the formula that we use to calculate multiplier. Okay, now another important part. That is the positive multiplier and negative multiplier. The concept that we have just studied, like leakage and the injection. Leakage, you know, withdrawal from the economy, and injection, you know, addition of money to the economy. So there are two concepts. One is your positive multiplier. You can say the multiplier, the positive multiplier effect, and other is your negative multiplier effect. Positive multiplier effect means when the increase in an injection or whether with an increase in the investment, the GDP, the real GDP increases, it's a positive effect. Negative effect, that with the decrease, with an initial decrease in the investment or injection, there the final decrease in GDP. Means when investment increases, the GDP also increases. This is your positive effect. When investment decreases, GDP also decreases. This is your negative effect. So let's see what does it says. When an initial increase in injection or a decrease in a leakage leads to a greater final increase in real GDP, this is your positive effect because both are increasing. Or we can say when an initial decrease in an injection or an increase in a leakage leads to a greater final decrease in real GDP. So the main thing is that when investments are more, okay, when investments are more, GDP, if GDP increases, then it's your positive multiplier effect. Or you, so this is your positive multiplier effect. You can also see it here, it is written decrease in leakage. Decrease in leakage means the portion of withdrawal, the portion of withdrawal from the economy decreases. So this is the concept of positive and negative multiplier effect. Now let's have a quick look at the assumptions of multiplier. The first thing it says that the supply curve of output should be elastic. What does it mean? It says that when the demand for goods and services increases, the supply also increases. When it can be seen that the consumers or the people are more interested towards a particular product, so the demand is, the increasing demand can be seen, so the supply can easily increase. This is the first assumption. Second, it says there is excess productive capacity in consumer goods industries. Means there is extra resources available, excess productive capacities are there, so that the supply of goods can be easily increased without any delay or without any difficulty. And the last assumption, it says that the supply of raw material and working capital should also be elastic. Means there should be flexibility, there should be excessive availability of the resources, so as and when required it can be done accordingly. So I guess the concept of multiplier is now clear to everyone, that it shows the relationship between two important perspectives. What are the two important perspectives? One is your investment and the other is your income. Then we have seen the other important part, the two different types, Kahn's and Keynes multiplier, and then we have the assumptions. So now with this we are completed with the first part of the lecture, that is your multiplier. Now coming to second interesting part, that is the accelerator. Now let's see what is accelerator. We have already seen that what accelerator is, it shows the relationship between consumption and the investment. So let's go ahead with accelerator. According to J.M. Clark, when income increases, people's spending power increases. That is pretty obvious. When an individual is earning less, he'll spend less. But when the income increases, the spending power will automatically increase. Their consumption increases and consequently the demand for consumer goods increases. In order to meet this enhanced demand, investment must increase to raise the productive capacity of the community. Now you know, when people are earning more, they have more purchasing power, they have more potential or capacity to spend. So now spending will be more and more, they will be interested in buying more of the goods. So now what it requires, as you can see, the demand for consumer good increases. When consumption increases, the demand for consumer goods also increases. So this is about the accelerator. Now let's see the accelerator effect. How does it works? Increase in consumer demand. How is consumer demand increased? Because now people are having more income, they have more money, so the demand for consumer good increases. Then when demand increases, firms get ready to set up or to produce more and more units of the particular product. And in order to produce a particular product, what does it require? It requires investment. So firms invest to meet the rising demand. So this is the accelerator effect, that in order to meet the increasing demand, the organizations or the firms have to start producing more and more units of that particular commodity. And in order to produce that particular product or that commodity, what does they require? It requires investment. So this is the accelerator effect. Now let's have a look at the assumptions of accelerator. Firstly, it says that it is assumed that there is no excess capacity existing in the consumer goods industries. Here it says that it is assumed that the role of consumer good, the excess availability, as it was said in the multiplier, that there is excess capacities or productive capacity available for consumer industries. Here it is assumed that here it is not at all available. The excess productive capacity is not available for consumer goods. And then it says in capital good industries, it has been assumed that there is an existence of surplus capacity. In the accelerator, they believe that capital industries have more excess because it's about investment. So it says that here capital industries has excess capacity, but not the consumer industries. Then output is flexible. The machine making industry or capital goods industry can increase its output whenever desired. The flexibility is available as per the requirement, as per the need of the hour. You can see the capital good industries can increase its output if it is required. So these are the assumptions of the accelerator. So I hope with this video you have a clear or better idea about what actually multiplier is and what accelerator is. If you don't understand anything or if you still have any doubts about this concept, you can just let me know. I'll just make it more clear. So that's all for the day. I hope you all have a great time. Keep learning, keep smiling. May God bless you all. Thank you.